Sperm is swimming in your eyeballs. Know that guy from Tinder you hooked up with the night you met him? He lives inside of you now. Forever. Casual sex is disgusting. Stop.
Sperm is alive. It is living cells. When it is injected into you, it swims and swims until it crashes headlong into a wall. And then it attaches and burrows into your flesh. If it's in your mouth, it swims and climbs into your nasal passages, inner ear, and behind your eyes. Then it digs in. It enters your bloodstream and collects in your brain and spine. Like stopping a sci-fi movie, it becomes a part of you. You can't get rid of it. We are only now beginning to understand the full power and ramifications of sexual intercourse.
Must be nice.
I feel the same way about dicks. If I had a dick, I'd walk around wanking it everywhere, leaving a Hansel and Gretel-esque breadcrumb trail of semen everywhere I went, enticing ladies to engage in sexy times.
But that's not how dicks work. And that's not how one gets sexy times with ladies. You should know this already.
Hashtag me too.
Please no.
Do you know what it takes for a woman to get pregnant? Because she needs to be calm and relaxed to ovulate. If she's stressed like a rape victim would be, it would be really hard for her to get pregnant. Not only that, but do you even realize how many families are dying to adopt newborn babies? Because the numbers are staggering for people like you that love to throw that shit out. You don't do much.
So to recap, you feminists want to ban a certain weapon because it was used in a school shooting, but are completely fine with abortion, which kills more babies. Hypocrisy.
We're now dead.
So here I am sitting on the toilet with a constant stream of blood flowing down my legs. You're probably wondering what happened next. Well, I placed an emergency surgery to have a Fuck. The doctors concluded that when I had inserted the tampon, there must have been a spider stuck inside the cotton. A manufacturing error. Once the tampon became wet and soggy, the spider came out of the cotton, causing scurrying up my uterus. The thing had camped out in my uterus for a while and eventually grew, feeding on my womanly flow. Once a month, the doctors measured the thing to be 8 inches and stretched from limb to limb. A huntsman spider.
That's fucking disgusting. Like, honestly, no one wants to know about that. In fact, they're the ones who create incels. Femmes are usually the gender with the shortest height, weak frame, poor facial features, etc. They ruin Chad genes.
Wow, I never thought about it like that before. Holy shit. That's not how genes work. Even Chads have mothers.
Butthurt femoid. My dad has a strong chin, but I got my mother's overbite chin. And yet I'm a male, and she's female. Quit lying.
Have you ever seen a fucking Punnett square? Both parents give genes. Your mother's overbite was just the dominant, unrelated to her being female.
And yet she's still passed in her inferior genes to me, proving OP's points that it's females that pass on shit genes. It's females that create incels.
You know more about biological facts, do you?
That face when you can't prove me wrong, so you just say I don't know anything. Lil, aka Rice Man.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, my name is Lil, aka Rice Man.
Holy shit, you're fucking stupid if you think that's how genetics work.
Vaginas are like women's little personal deep concealment storage.
Oh shit, what the fuck? What?
Loss of blood is a hemorrhage. Yes, this includes the menstrual cycle. Ancestors considered every lost egg an abortion / miscarriage. The loss of a potential child was just as severe as the loss of a fully developed being. Because every time you lose an egg, you lose an aspect of your life force. Reabsorb your egg through your mind. On average, a healthy yoni menstruates maybe 2 to 3 times total.
Oh yeah!
Every time a
womb. Womb man.
Menstruates, uterine lining is stripped, which is necessary for the child. Geniuses are created in healthy wombs. Look into reducing the menstrual cycle naturally in alternative holistic methods. Regulations for birth control.
Sluts. Sure. Why do you think the sex dries up when she popped out all the baby she wants? Sex no longer serves a purpose in her life unless she's a massive whore. That killed me on the inside to say.